I'm Gayle Laakmann McDowell, author of Crack and Coding Interview. Today we're going to talk about stacks and queues.
Stacks and queues have a lot of things in common. They are both linear data structures in that you have one element and then another element and then another element. They are both flexible with their sizes, so you don't have to allocate initially them to have a size of like 50. You can just add elements as you go and then also shrink it down. The main difference comes in how elements are removed from the stack or from the queue. A stack is what would be called a LIFO data structure, last in, first out. It's much like an actual stack of plates. The last plate you put on top of that stack, that's going to be the first one you remove. It's LIFO, last in, first out. A queue, though, is FIFO, first in, first out. So think about a queue or a line of people waiting to get into a movie theater. When the movie theater doors open, they don't first serve the person who just hopped into line 5 seconds ago. They serve the person who got in line the very, very beginning, an hour or two ago. And then the next person, and the next person. The very first person in is the very first person removed. That's what FIFO means, first in, first out. Now let's look at the code for these data structures. Here's the framework for what our queue class needs. We need this inner class, which is a node, and it just keeps a pointer or a variable that represents the data, and then also each node needs a pointer to the next node, and we gave ourselves a little constructor here. Now, when we implement a queue or when we use a queue, we're going to add things here to the tail and remove from the head, because we want to add from one side and remove from the other. Okay, and then we need these methods. So let's walk through and actually start implementing these methods. So isEmpty is very simple. Just return if head is null. If head is null, then the queue is empty, otherwise it's not. Okay, and then peak. Well, peak is gonna do is just return head.data. Now this will throw an exception when head is null. If you want, you can go explicitly check for that exception. Okay, so the add and remove are the sort of interesting ones. So with add, what we want to do here is add to the tail. So first thing we need to do is actually go and create this node. Then if tail is not null, let tail's next pointer point over to this node, and then update the tail. Then what we want to do is we want to make sure that, you know, there could be a case where the queue is completely empty, in which case head is null. And so if head is null, then this value should, head should also be this node. Okay, so that's all add has to do. Okay, now for remove, we want to remove from the head of the linked list. So first thing we're going to do is actually get this head data. Then we want to do is essentially move that head. So set head equals to head.next, and that basically removes it from the queue. And then we need to say, okay, if head is now null, make sure you set tail to null too, and then go and return that data. So that's the basics of how we implement a queue. Follows pretty logically from the actual design and the algorithms behind it. Now let's look at the stack implementation. Much like with the queue, we have this inner class that is a node class, has a pointer to the next node. Here though, we're gonna wanna add and remove from the top. So we just need a top, we don't need a head and a tail anymore. And then these are the methods we're gonna wanna implement. The implementation for isEmpty is pretty straightforward. Just if top is null, return true, essentially. And then for peak, I'm gonna ignore null pointer checks just to keep my code really, really simplistic for you all. All peak needs to do is return top.data. Okay, so push is the first interesting method. So first, we need to actually create this new node. So new node, data. Then, this new node is going to become the top. So node.next is going to point over to the kind of old top. And then the top points over to node. So that's all push needs to do. Now for pop. Well, so pop is going to, first we're going to want to return the old head's data. So first we need to actually just get that data. So head dot data, sorry, top.data. Then top just should be moved and pointed over to the new top or the next element down. And then we just need to return that data. Pretty straightforward. Now, again, I ignored null pointer checks, but if you really want to be complete, you'd probably want to do some sort of check that says, hey, if top is null, throw an exception, if something like that. But that's the basics of how stacks and queues are implemented. They're not too tricky to implement, just a little bit of pointers and making sure to update those things correctly. So now that you've seen both stacks and queues and the implementation of them, why don't you try these out on a new stack or queue problem? Good luck.